mi trovo al London Film Festival lungo il red carpet della premiere europea del nuovo film tratto da David Copperfield, uno dei più amati romanzi di Charles Dickens. Il film è diretto dal regista italo-scozzese Armando Iannucci, nel ruolo di David Copperfield, Dev Patel. Nel cast anche Hugh Laurie, Tilda Swinton e Peter Capaldi.
So I think you scored the record for the highest number of characters, Dickensian characters played, first Catherine and then Clara and then Dora. Yeah, which one was your favorite?
Well, we actually did it chronologically, so when we filmed it, I did Clara first, and it was really nice being able to not have them overlap, so I really said goodbye to Clara, and then we started Dora, who's like so different, and like physically as well, so different. So I don't know, whichever one I was playing, I felt really attached to. I feel Clara has such a terrible time, I feel really connected to her. She tries her best in circumstances that she just has no control of, so I felt a lot of empathy for Clara. Yeah.
I translate Charles Dickens into Italian for Italian publishing house. Yes,
it was a lot more diverse.
So your character is actually, yeah, it is. Your character in the movie is actually a mixture of two different characters in the book, right?
So yeah. It was really interesting. So she's Rosa Dartle and Mrs. Steerforth. And I actually found that out when I read the book. Armando didn't really talk about that too much, but she has the scar like Rosa Dartle had. She has some of her passion and a strangely obsessive relationship with James, who's obviously my son, but I transposed that to a mother-son relationship and just made her as obsessive about her son.
And what impact do you think she had on David's life and progress?
Mrs. Steerforth?
Yeah.
I think it's really interesting. She is quite judgmental. I think she sees him and she senses trouble, which is so difficult for David because he's such a lovely, open-hearted character. But of course, her son's relationship with David ends in tragedy for her. And so I think it's a really tense, stressful relationship and a really different tone for the story, different to the rest of the story.
Did you know the book before this film?
I've listened to the audiobook, and so I have a slight understanding of what's going on.
What's your favorite part of the book?
Well, I like action scenes. So like when David's always been like running around. Yeah, that's quite fun because I like action.
What was the funniest moment on set?
Funniest moment. Well, for me, I had to get pulled through a window, and then like I was. That was quite fun.
Have you read any other Dickens novel?
No, I haven't. I've sort of just just sort of read David Copperfield because I'm in it.
David Copperfield è un racconto altamente autobiografico. Nel film infatti troviamo tantissimi riferimenti non solo a dettagli dei libri, ma anche alla vita di Charles Dickens.
I saw some references to Dickens' life, such as in the opening we have like the public reading.
Yeah. You know,
did you do any research about Dickens' life as well?
Absolutely. I mean, this is kind of based on his journey, and that's why it was so close to him and very exposing. So I did do a fair bit of research. Armando is kind of Wikipedia for anything Dickens, he knows everything, so we had a lot to go off, yeah.
Dora is notoriously based on Mariah Bidnell. Did you do any type of research beyond just reading the book?
Well, no, actually, we were told not to read the book, which you probably won't like as a translator of it, but he said that he wanted us all to read it afterwards, but he said he wanted us to kind of come at it from our modern perspective, and that the characters would kind of just still come through as they were in the book because he was so connected to the book itself. So yeah, it wasn't till afterwards that I read it and was like, I think I did a good job.
This movie kind of reads in between the lines and brings out a new level of the story. So what do you think it shows of your character that people might not necessarily get from the book?
Thank you so much. What they wouldn't get from the book. I think that although, you know, we've kept the language true to its time, there is a contemporary feel to it. And I think this will be relatable to a lot of different audiences. So I think that's what will be different. I think it's going to be more of an accessible Dickens. And I think that's important. You know, I think we should reach as many people as we can with something like this.
I think you get to see her entire arc played out really well. You get to see the struggles that she goes through, and which also is in the book, but obviously just brought to life a little bit
bit more because it's on screen.
This is a, you know, I remember standing there on the other side of the barriers waiting 3 hours for Will Smith, and I managed to get a picture of his forehead on my Nokia. So this is a big honor coming here. I mean, it's a tremendous amount of pressure stepping into the shoes of David Copperfield, who's essentially Charles Dickens' most beloved character, and it's kind of autobiographical in a way. But I had a wonderful cast, an amazing filmmaker, and Armando, the director, just pushed me to try and find some truth and some of me in there.
And people tend to think that Adora is a very silly character, but I think she has a very deep meaning.
I agree that she's got so much more depth than people think, and I actually based, in terms of the character that's closest to me, I would say it was Dora. Like, she's full of whimsy and fun, and she also kind of, she's aware of the amount of power that she has and where that lies, and it lies in her being pretty and amiable, and that's like, that's a kind of power move for her in a way, because she's in a society where she has no agency. She's rich in that way, but otherwise she's still a woman. So I find her really interesting in that, that she's chosen to just be like, no, I'll be silly and find it all, just who cares, and that's like her coping mechanism. Yeah, exactly.
Dickens did public readings of his works and obviously couldn't read the whole book, so he had to select some parts that he thought were more representative. If you had to do the same with the movie and just pick one scene to represent the essence of the movie, which one would you choose?
Something to represent the whole essence of the movie. Gosh, I don't know. There are so many scenes. Maybe something with Uriah Heep and Ben Whishaw and Dev. I don't know. That's quintessentially Dickens, and I don't know. I can't pick one. That's too much. I love them all.
To represent the essence of the movie. Oh, that's interesting. I mean, selfishly, I remember the day when we were shooting the school scene where we had most of the characters there that day filming. And I remember looking around and seeing all ages and all backgrounds. And as an artist, being so proud to be a part of it and saying, like, this is really how I hope we represent the English acting community as well. So that was my favorite scene in a way.
It's so hard. One scene from the movie, maybe the there's too many. I can't choose. I'm sorry. I can't choose. There's too many.
Okay.
When you watch it, you'll see it's too difficult.
Okay. Your interpretation of Dora was very, very close to the way I always imagined her.
That's so limiting. Also, I think people talk badly about Dora, and I'm like, no, she's not a fool. Yes.
Well, normally when you're doing movies, you know, everyone's telling you to be still and make it smaller because the camera can enter you through your pores. It's that close. But actually, Armando was pushing us to those good old days of Buster Keaton and Chaplin and, you know, Rowan Atkinson. It's just to be able to be so physical and have such razor sharp dialogue to back it up was amazing.
If you could play any other character from the Dickensian universe, which one would you pick?
Oh, gosh. Would it be Nancy from Oliver, maybe?
You know, interesting.
With that heart, you know, she's always believing in love, and I just think it's such a beautiful soul she has, yeah.
From any book, I would play Nancy in Oliver Twist.
Nancy.
Everybody's saying Nancy.
Fagin. Fagin's a great character.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's more original. Thank you very much.
Grazie.
Come vi chiamate?
Copperfield.
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 Lui è Crafton Struthersfield.
David Copperfield.
Oh, asini!
Qui non sono ammessi gli asini!
Che donna straordinaria, così cortese!